Hello everyone and welcome. We have more leaks and rumors for Breath of the Wild 2, Twilight Princess HD, Oracle of Ages, and Oracle of Seasons, as well as some other games. After we get through the credibility of this person, we will go into my thoughts on all of this. I wanted to quickly add this in, we have a new giveaway going on for a $50 Nintendo eShop card. If you want to enter to win, it will be given out on December 24th. Simply ask us any question about Breath of the Wild or Breath of the Wild 2 that you would like to get our opinion on, which we will answer on the next episode of our Zelda podcast, the Hylian Gamescast. And the winner will be announced on December 24th. Some of you, including our great friend Cliff, have reached out and asked our opinion on this, so instead of having long replies giving our thoughts on everything, we thought it would be best to cover it here, and if you would like us to go more in depth with everyone else's thoughts, we can cover it in our Hylian Gamescast. Yes, I know, you've heard this a million times. I'm kind of getting tired of covering this, especially from this specific person, who I honestly think is just a troll account at this point. Tweet says, Zelda Breath of the Wild sequel is coming to the end of the development cycle very soon, so they should release the game next year with no delays, even if that means a December 2022 release. Light, Time, and Sky was some of the key names they use in the development cycle. It will be the main event for the next E3. Oracle remakes for 2023 Plus and Wind Waker and Twilight Princess HD should be released before the end of summer next year. Or at least one of them, since I don't know if they're still planning to release both as a single pack. Newsflash, they never were. If Link's Awakening and Skyward Sword HD released as a single game for a $60 price tag, games they 100% know would sell a lot better than those, such as Twilight Princess HD or Wind Waker HD, are not going to be discounted basically to $30 each at release, so they can have a bundle. If they did release at the same time, maybe you could see like a $100 bundle or something. They do similar with all of the Pokemon games where they release two in the same package, but obviously it's not the same $60 package. If you have followed along with our videos in the past, you will remember some videos we made where we took a big list of rumors from this person and seen that out of dozens and dozens of supposed leaks, only a few end up being true. Some, such as all of those Oracle of Ages and Oracle of Seasons rumors, Wind Waker HD, Twilight Princess HD, The Collections, all meant to be coming out last year, or if we go by his earlier tweets, late 2020 or early 2020, then we have tweets from 2019 where they were supposed to release. Basically, this person comes out, says this game is releasing here, and when it doesn't, about 6 months later he comes out saying that it will be releasing within the next 6 months. We can clearly see tweets where he lists the same thing over and over every year or every 6 months. And just as I told Cliff, if you say something is going to release every single year, eventually that year is going to come. I think at one point he had like 6 different Zelda games releasing in the same year or two. He's basically the main source of most of these Zelda rumors that plagued last year. Some of the rumors saying it was almost done, some saying they have been in development, a big Zelda collection was coming. This is the source for most of those. We can look here and just with Zelda, not the many other franchises he has leaks for that ended up being wrong, just Zelda. Yeah, let's loop back to a previous video that is still very relevant and see what that has to say. So let's take a quick look at the history of this leaker. This same leaker stated these games would release in 2022, then switched it to 2023, hinted at reveals in 2021 that never happened. Breath of the Wild 2 would release in the fourth quarter of 2020 or the first quarter of 2021. He even said they have Wind Waker HD prepared to release just in case Breath of the Wild 2 is delayed. And obviously neither of those came. The Metroid Prime trilogy also got several different release dates for the first half of 2020, again in 2021, and he is now saying 2022, as well as giving Metroid Prime 4 similar release windows. He said a full Zelda collection would be coming in the second half of 2021, along with Zelda Wii U ports. Then they give a new date for it 6 months or a year later. Some people who have screenshotted or even linked back to all of his past wrong leaks, apparently they've been blocked, even if they're not saying anything negative, simply asking why so many different release dates didn't happen, or why when one of these announcement windows came and went, he just changed it to the next year. We have many, many, many more examples just like this. But let's look at his recent tweet about three Oracle games releasing. So most fans know, will Breath of the Wild 2 release in 2022? Obviously. That is the plan that Nintendo has been sticking to. Will Twilight Princess HD and Wind Waker HD, or other remakes such as Oracle of Ages and Oracle of Seasons, come to Nintendo Switch or their next console? Obviously, yes. With Wind Waker HD and Twilight Princess HD specifically, those games, to port from the Wii U to the Switch, would only take about 3 months for a small team to do. Theoretically, it could have been finished long ago and then just held off for the right time. Honestly, they were probably made around the same time that all of the other Wii U ports were brought to Switch, but I don't know. The only game that I know for sure, or that I believe the rumors and leaks for, has been Ocarina of Time HD, which is what I've been saying this entire time. This is because Nintendo at all times has at least 4 to 6 different Zelda teams, all working on different Zelda games. Tantalus with Twilight Princess HD and Skyward Sword HD. We don't know what is coming from them now or what they're working on. Most likely another Zelda game. They would be the team to ask to port Twilight Princess HD over. Grezzo, who made Ocarina of Time 3D, Majora's Mask 3D, helped on other 3DS Zelda games, but most recently released Link's Awakening, is thought to recently have finished 2 Zelda games and began work on a new third unannounced Zelda game. We do know for a fact that yes, they are working on a new Zelda game, and I believe one of these three rumored Zelda games was actually Ocarina of Time HD, as it necessarily wouldn't take that long to port from the 3DS to the Switch. The same obviously goes for Majora's Mask 3D, or HD as well. Again, depending on the type of port or remake, it could be done in as little time as 3 months. Porting HD remasters from the 3DS to the Switch is kind of what Grezzo is known for. Monolith Soft has their own official Zelda team now, either helping on Breath of the Wild 2 or their own Zelda project. Koei Tecmo, thanks to the huge success of Age of Clams, yes, Clams, not Calams or Calamity, is likely working on a new unannounced DLC, if not an entirely new crossover like they did with Fire Emblem Warriors. So what would you like to see? A Mario Warriors? Maybe Luigi's Death Stare can come back. Or how insane would a Kirby All-Stars Warriors be? Just sucking up groups of 100 guys. But I have to say, Donkey Kong Warriors would truly be in contest for 2022's Game of the Year. Or a Splatoon crossover would actually be really, really interesting. And of course, Nintendo has their own main team working on Breath of the Wild 2, as well as them confirming they had a team working on a 2D Zelda game for the Switch. And remember, long ago, it was also confirmed they were working on a Zelda mobile phone game. So yes, there's confirmation of at least 4 to 6 or more Zelda games all in development right now. Some have even been in development up to 5 years or longer, some only a year or two. We aren't sure what other unannounced Zelda teams Nintendo has either, or what third-party smaller games may be in development, similar to Cadence of Hyrule. And it's possible not all of these teams would be working on remasters or remakes. What if Nintendo's main team were to be focusing on Breath of the Wild 2 with their new Breath of the Wild open-air style formula, while Monolith Soft or Grezzo, who has a ton of experience on traditional style Zelda games with Ocarina of Time 3D, Majora's Mask 3D, Link's Awakening, and helping on the other original Zelda games, they would be perfect to ask to work on a more traditional Ocarina of Time style Zelda game. I think everyone would love for them to be working on a third Hero of Time game to go along with their work on Ocarina of Time and Majora's Mask. But with that said, go check out our previous interview with Joe from Breath of the Wild and Age of Calamity, who voices Daruk and Yunobo. It was a really fun interview. Daniel somehow managed to cheat and beat him on our weekly quiz, which was 10 trivia questions about Gorons from Breath of the Wild and Age of Calamity. And we may be having someone else who works on those games coming on in the next few weeks, so look forward to that. Thank you all for watching, and happy holidays. But those are just my hopes and wishes. These were all my thoughts. It's not like we know anyone who actually works at Nintendo. We have a few new Patreon supporters that I would like to give a thank you to. If you would like your own shoutout, then head over to patreon.com/gameoverjesse, where you can receive a ton of different rewards while helping us out. Those of you who are just donating a single dollar, that really does help more than you would think. Thank you, Monica Spath, Nodnarb, Shadow to Us, SoberRx, Andromoy, Natsu, Rusty Caulfield, Zoe M, Candy, David Guthman, Ashton Wren, BKRS7, Blargnar, Chad Costin, Gus Calvo, Henry, Jesse Birch, Jesse Wood, Jon Snow, Lerulean Sheep, Lovable Christie, Mr. Monocled Metroid, SuperNX64, and Zane.